blue and gray. Since the beginning of civilization, humans have sought to understand both the divine and our physical world. And as time has passed, two threads of thought have evolved: spirituality and science. But as science delves further into the unknown, we find that science merges with God, the Absolute. As this merging occurs, we find that science is proving many of the concepts written in the world's great scriptures. In recent years, as the spiritual elevation of the earth has been increasing, scientists have spent more time researching the aspects of science which are closely aligned with the divine. And as a result, scientists have made some amazing discoveries, such as one particle existing simultaneously in two places, the third eye, the aura, the power of prayer, and the zero-point field, which contains infinite energy. It seems we have reached the golden age where science and spirituality walk together hand in hand. The scientific revolution is of great importance because as humans become more scientifically advanced, they require great wisdom in order to use their technology for peaceful and constructive purposes. And with spiritual wisdom combined with scientific knowledge, they possess the tools to transform the world into a paradise for everyone to enjoy. Greetings on today's Science and Spirituality. We'll be taking a look at the scientific perspective on meditation. The Center for Mindfulness in Medicine at the University of Massachusetts Medical School is the world's oldest and largest research-based stress reduction program. This highly effective program involves meditation, gentle stretching, yoga, instruction in stress management, and group support sessions. Participants in the program report an increased ability to relax. High blood pressure, sleep disorders, headaches, and chronic pain disappear. And participants often notice an enhanced ability to cope with enduring pains. Many people also report improved self-esteem, increased energy, and greater enthusiasm for life. Over the past 28 years, more than 17,000 people have experienced these positive, lasting changes thanks to the Center for Mindfulness in Medicine. Meditation is no longer seen as a mystical practice by mainstream science. In fact, each year millions of people worldwide are learning how to meditate. People around the world are rediscovering the meditative roots of their own spiritual traditions. The rituals of prehistoric shamans and ancient Hindu scriptures incorporate meditation. Shakyamuni Buddha also retreated under the banyan tree. Christian monks have been meditating to be in communion with God for thousands of years. Throughout the first millennium, Jewish mystics and Islamic Sufis alike practiced meditation to be closer to God. And today, in a modern world that necessitates the quest for inner peace, different forms of meditation are being offered in various settings, in schools, hospitals, law firms, government buildings, company offices, and penitentiaries. In response to this global trend of introspective awareness, research studies on meditation have increased dramatically in recent years. When we return, let's take a look at what science has discovered with regards to the effects of meditation. We'll be right back after this brief message. Welcome back to Science and Spirituality. Welcome back to Science and Spirituality on Supreme Master Television. Today, the number of scientific studies on meditation is increasing. Recently, science has developed sophisticated technologies to see the brain in action. Dr. Andrew Newberg, a neurologist at the University of Pennsylvania, USA, told BBC World Service's Discovery program, "I think we are poised at a wonderful time in our history to be able to explore religion and spirituality in a way which was never thought possible." Dr. Newberg and his team studied a group of Tibetan Buddhist monks as they meditated for approximately 1 hour. The scans provided remarkable insights into what goes on in the brain during meditation. The brain scans showed that there was an increase in activity in the front part of the brain, the frontal cortex. The frontal cortex, known as the most highly evolved part of the brain, is activated when attention is focused on a particular task. It is also responsible for reasoning, abstract thinking, planning for the future, self-conscious awareness, and emotions. During meditation, the frontal cortex is active. The brain is paying attention to something. It is aware of a new reality. In another study by Dr. Greg Jacobs at Harvard Medical School, one group of research participants was shown how to meditate, while the control group was given books on tape to listen to. Over the next several months, the meditating group not only showed the same alertness in the frontal areas as the Buddhist monks did, they showed lower activity in the parietal lobe. The parietal lobe, located near the top of the head, orients us in time and space. As this region slows down in activity, the person can close his or her sense of spatial boundaries. That is probably why during meditation, people feel a sense of infinite space or a oneness with the universe. Meditation is also often associated with feelings of bliss. At the University of Wisconsin at Madison, Dr. Richard Davidson has shown that meditating shifts activity in the front of our brains from the right hemisphere to the left. This corresponds with the fact that people who have a negative disposition show a great deal of activity in the right prefrontal area, whereas people who rely more on the left prefrontal side are more enthusiastic, have more interests, tend to relax more, and feel happier. In short, Dr. Davidson says that meditating regularly increases one's contentment. When we return, more scientific findings on the brain in a state of meditation. We'll be right back after this brief message. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Science and Spirituality. Welcome back to Science and Spirituality. In scientific research, it is now well established that during meditation, relaxation increases as conscious thought decreases. We can see evidence of this in terms of brain waves measured by an EEG device. Beta waves, which are associated with consciousness, active thinking, and concentration, decrease significantly. The decrease in beta waves indicates that the brain has ceased active processing information. Even first-time meditators exhibit this pattern after 20 minutes of meditation. After 8 weeks of training, research participants showed a significant change in brain wave patterns. Alpha waves, which are associated with conscious thought, dropped from around 44% to 30%. At the same time, there is a rise in the prevalence of theta waves, which are associated with deep relaxation. In the past, however, relaxation was never the ultimate goal of the meditation. The original purpose of meditation has always been a spiritual one, to contact the inner self or the God power within, and make use of this power while on earth to lead fuller, happier, more peaceful lives. Perhaps this is what is meant by being in heaven while on earth. And increasingly, scientists are saying that the study of reality in its inner dimension is just as beneficial to humankind as the study of the physical world. When people have a spiritual experience, they often feel that their heightened sense of reality in that moment is far greater and clearer than their usual everyday sense of reality. Dr. Newberg even suggests that since the sense of spiritual reality is more powerful and clear, perhaps that sense of reality is more accurate than our scientific everyday sense of reality. In the near future, our scientific tools may be sophisticated enough to show us more about how meditation works. But of course, the best way to know is to experience it ourselves. Thank you for joining us on Science and Spirituality. This program airs every Monday here on Supreme Master Television. Coming up after noteworthy news is Words of Wisdom. Please stay tuned for an inspiring lecture by Supreme Master Ching Hai.